21. Got to kind of roll them and get the grease all over them. This is a waterproof synthetic green grease. I use this for marine applications too. It's supposedly some good stuff, I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Okay, so here's the lower clamp. This is the original one from the CT. I'm going to use the XR100 top clamp. I think I need to tie this triple tree in place before I flip it so that it doesn't let any of the ball bearings get away, or bearing balls, I should say. No, that's not going to work. This works better because I can pull some pressure on it this way. A couple of half hitches to hold it. Yeah. That should work. Thank you. The top is a little easier because the stem will help hold the balls in place. And again, 21. And roll them around in the grease a little bit. Try to get them positioned correctly. You got to kind of push them out away from the stem and into the bearing grease. Actually, I guess that would be the bearing shell, and this would be the bearing race. There we go. Here's the nut that holds everything in place. Just make sure I'm not cross-threading that. top threads are a little rough, so I had to move the camera out of the way to get some leverage. Once I got past the top threads, it was all good. Okay. Now I can untie this little piece of rope. Tight is all we need, I think. Because there'll be another nut on top of that anyway. I'll have to trim a little of that off. See, this is the original CT stem because the XR100 stem is too short. See, So I've got to cut some of this off so that nut will fit over it. And there's going to be enough thread engagement there to work. This actually fits down over that nut, so it leaves enough. So time for the hacksaw. Now that the hacksaw work is done, it's time to trowel fit this top clamp. I'm not going to tighten it until I have the forks on it. But it looks like it's probably going to work.